In this problem, we are given several points on a graph, and our job is to identify the ordered pair that corresponds to each point. So for example, this point here, C, we need to identify its coordinates and write our answer in point notation in this area here. So if you happen to have generated a MathAS question where the scale on the axes is not 1, you have a little bit of work to do to determine what the scale is. So for example, I notice on the x-axis they label this 100, and I also notice that counting from the origin there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 equal spaces that the 100 was broken into. If you take something of length 100 and break it into 5 equal pieces, because 100 divided by 5 is 20, the labels would be as follows. This would be 20, this would be 40, continuing to count by 20s, this would be 60, and finally this would be 80. Then I repeat and do the same thing on the scale for the y-axis. On the y-axis they labeled this 500, and it also has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 equal divisions. A segment of length 500 divided into 5 equal pieces means that each piece would be of length 100. 500 divided by 5 is 100. So I would label this 100, 200, 300, and 400. Now I'm ready to label my points. Let's look at point C first. Point C, to label its first coordinate, I look along the x-axis and notice that from 0 I have to go over this far, which is 40 units from the origin. So I would put a 40 here, comma. Now I need to tell someone how high they would have to go to reach that point. Going up each space is 100 units. So that's 100, 200, 300, 400. So the output, or sometimes called the y-coordinate of the point, would be 400. And you would type this into MathAS just as shown there. It would be 40, 400. Now let's look at point A. To get to point A, we need to move in the negative direction along the x-axis. Each unit was 20 units, so this would be negative 20, negative 40, negative 60, negative 80, negative 100. 20 units more in the negative direction would put us at negative 120. So the x-coordinate of point A is negative 120. And then we need to move down in the negative direction on the y-axis, or the vertical axis, to get to point A. But remember that each mark on the vertical axis represents 100 units. Since we're going down, we consider that the negative direction. So this would be negative 100, this would be negative 200, negative 300, and if you continued on this way, you would see that you have to go 8 spaces below the x-axis in the negative direction to get down as far as point A, and by my labels that would be negative 800. So the output of point A, or the y-coordinate as it's usually called, would be negative 800. Let's look at point E for a second. Point E is 20, 40, 60, 80, 100, 120 units to the right of the origin, so its first coordinate would be a positive 120, and its y value or output would be negative because it's below the horizontal axis, or the x-axis if you want. But remember, going down one space in the negative direction here really represents 100 units. Our vertical axis was such that each space represented 100 units. This being in the negative direction, the label here would be negative 100. So my output coordinate, or my y-coordinate if you want, would be negative 100. Now, rather than labeling the rest of the points, I want to show you what would happen if you were to generate a different scale. Suppose you generated this question in MathAS. Let's just look at how you would label things on the coordinate axes. For example, the label here on the x-axis is 10 units, and because it's 10 units, but it's being divided into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 equal pieces. To find the length of each of those 5 equal pieces, we'd have to take our 10 units and divide by 5. So we would get that each one is 2 units wide. So now that I know that each one is 2 units wide, I could label this 2, 4, 6, 8, and then of course 10. And then if you wanted to label point D, for example, you would have to move over to x equals 12. And that would be the first coordinate of point D. On the vertical axis, or if you want the y-axis, the first label I see is 1,000, but again, this interval here of length 1,000 is broken up into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 equal spaces. So if you take something of length 1,000 units and divide it into 5 equal lengths, because 1,000 divided by 5 is 200, that means each space should be labeled 200 units. So you could label this 200, you could label this 400, 600, and 800, and then you could continue on. So for example, if you were looking at point D, since it's one space above the x-axis or horizontal axis, its label would be 200, because moving over, you can see that the height of this point is 200 units above the x-axis, or if you want, just one space. So the y-coordinate here, or the output of the function, would be labeled 200.